Alright, so if you stuck through this entire series, you should know everything you need to begin streaming on Twitch with OBS Studio. To go live, all we have to do is click Start Streaming. Let's take a little bit and talk about how we can improve our stream. First, I recommend having a friend watching your stream and giving you feedback so that you can make any adjustments as needed. You'll want to adjust things like audio levels for your game and mic sound, lighting for your webcam, or make some small tweaks to your overlay. If you'd like, you can join the Nerd or Die Discord server and hop into our Stream Checks channel. The invite link will be in the description below. Feel free to tag me in a message, and if I'm available, I'll stop by and provide feedback. I'd also like to encourage anyone else in the server to help others and give constructive criticism as well. To give you guys an idea about the first time that I streamed, I actually couldn't figure out why my webcam was upside down and I had really bad audio issues. So don't worry if you have a couple of issues when starting out, we all had to start somewhere. If you'd like, leave your Twitch name in the comments below. I do my best to go through any of the comments and check out either the live stream or even the past broadcast and provide any feedback. Don't forget, you can also watch your own past broadcast to see how everything is looking and sounding. Another thing you'll want to look for is if you're dropping frames. You can check for this information at the bottom of OBS Studio while you're live. Dropping frames means that parts of your stream are not being sent to the servers. This will cause buffering issues for your viewers, and this issue can be caused by a lot of different problems. I'll link a helpful article from the OBS site in the description as well, but I do plan on making a full video guide that covers this topic. While streaming, you can also go to your Twitch dashboard. If you have access to a second monitor or even a tablet, you can use this to monitor your chat messages, as well as to see the status of your connection with Twitch. Don't forget, if you change games or need to update your title, you can do that here as well. Oh, and if you happen to be watching your own stream while you're streaming, make sure it's on mute or viewers will hear an echo. Now, if you followed this guide, thank you so much for tuning in. If you found it helpful, please consider sharing it on any websites, forums, or social media. While this video is the last of the core OBS Studio series, I will be making more resources and tutorials for OBS and streaming on Twitch, so look forward to those. Let me know if there's any topics that you think that we should cover in the future in the comments below. And if you like this video, please give it a like, and if you really like the video, make sure to subscribe for more great gaming and streaming content from Nerd or Die. Thanks for watching.